Some view the problem of evil as a justification for atheism. But the existence of evil does not mean God stops existing. It just means our understanding of evil is grossly lacking. Let's consider a few points to expand on this. Number one, test. However many times we hear this, it remains the truth. In the Quran, chapter 29, verse 2, we're told, after belief, tests will follow. And just like any effective test, there needs to be worthy problems and challenges to prove our worthiness. Number two, appreciation. We value cold because of heat, day because of night, and holidays because of school and work. The saying, absence makes the heart grow fonder, is quite apt in showing how we can become unappreciative and bored when we have something all of the time. Number three, teaching us. We have the pixel, Allah has the picture. Many a time we see a problem as the only thing that exists, and we fail to realize it is a mere puzzle piece in a grand picture. A thread in a tapestry, a tile in a glorious mosaic, a scene in a play. You get the point. In other words, as we progress in life, we soon realize that it was our difficult moments that were our greatest teachers. Number four, closer to Allah. When you're going through problems, notice how your prayers become more conscious, your du'as become more sincere, and you become drawn more towards God. It doesn't sound as bad now, does it? Number five, removes sins. A hardship for a believer is a means to remove their bad deeds. This is vital because if we're raised on the day of judgment with sins, then we'll have to spend time in hell to remove them. So getting them removed here is considerably a better deal, don't you think? Number six, paradise. People with hardships and less wealth will enter paradise before those who are rich, because the rich will have to give an account of every penny they earned. Number seven, better character. According to studies, people who are considered less good-looking have more patience, less feeling of entitlement, and better manners. Number eight, punishment. Health problems, disabilities are considered a disadvantage by our limited understandings. We are duped into thinking health, wealth, and fame are measures of success, despite having a lot of examples where such affluent, quote-unquote, people have taken their own lives because of depression, power struggles, and revenge. Suffice to say, every social group has a different test. So, what are my closing thoughts? Well, we as believers are quick to blame God when things go wrong. For example, when we fail an exam, we get annoyed at God, when in reality, we didn't revise as much as we should have. When a relationship fails, upon reflection, we'll realize that it was the lack of time invested and lack of open communication that was the problem. In other words, guys, the fault is ours, but God tends to become our scapegoat. And also, this word patience gets misused a lot. Being patient doesn't mean you sit idle and wait for the help of Allah to descend. No, this is a mockery of the word. You are required to do what is in your power, exhaust your means, then be patient with the outcome. In other words, do your best, Allah will do the rest. So diamonds are made when carbon undergoes great pressures. Roses start off as a seed growing in manure and darkness. Butterflies start off as slimy, unimpressive caterpillars. Realize you are just going through a rough patch. Change your mentality. View your problems as opportunities for growth rather than punishments, weaknesses. You are better than that. Yeah? Now say it with me. I can do this, inshallah.